Hi, welcome again. So in today's video, we'll be looking into a sample scenario-based question, and this will help you to crack part 2 TOCAF examination. Now in part 2, you should remember that the maximum point that you can get is 5. Okay, that's the max point that you can get for the correct answer. Now the second best answer, if you don't select the best answer, but the second best answer, then you'll be getting the 3 points. And the third best will be getting 1 point, okay? And the distractor, you know, that's the incorrect answer, will get 0, okay? So the trick first is to, you know, ensure that you find the distractor, the incorrect answer, so that, you know, you can eliminate that completely, okay? So that's the trick. So let's first read the scenario. Now, if you want at this stage, you can pause the video and try out yourself and compare with me or compare with my answer later, or you can just continue with me. Let's read through the scenario. So you are serving here as a lead architect in a multinational company that operates production facilities in 24 countries and sells products in some 100 countries. Okay, so it has got 3 sector: transportation, energy and automation. And it has got several business unit across this sector. Now an executive vice president heads each of this business unit, and in a traditional way each business unit has acted independently. Okay, now a consultancy firm has recommended a realignment that will enhance the sharing of product information cross business unit. Okay, so these three silos, the three sectors which were acting as a silos, now will be sharing the we'll be going forward with the sharing of product information. Okay, so that's one thing, that kind of you need to know, that, you know, a consulting firm has has basically come up with an idea of sharing of product information. Okay, the other thing is that, you know, this company is already practicing TOGAF 9.2. okay, so that's one thing. The other thing kind of you should be aware of, always remember, in the part 2 scenario question there will be a lot of extra information, or as I said in my previous videos, there's a lot of noise. Okay, so just kind of try to avoid the noise, include it so that it kind of makes you more confused. It basically makes the question more confusing. So the first paragraph, definitely kind of you can, you know, just ignore it. The whole idea is that, you know, there's a consultancy firm which basically recommend realignment of these three silos. Okay, and this firm is already using or it's already been practicing TOGAF 9.2. okay, and the other thing is the company already has enterprise architecture practice 9.2, okay, and an architecture development program has been created to address the development of these capabilities. Okay, and it's about to commence. So it's basically a new ADM is supposed to start, where, you know, we'll be kind of realigning or these silos so that the information can be shared between these silos. Okay, but now at the most recent meeting of the corporate board, the chairman of the board expressed a concern at the risk to the business. Okay, so this is very important. Okay, it's basically they are looking at some kind of a risk to the business if this kind of an practice is rolled out to the company. Okay, so that's kind of gives you an idea that, you know, it's something to do with the risk alignment or the risk assessment in TOGAF. Okay, so that's the scenario. Again, you know, try to avoid noise with the actual core content. So the actual core content is, there's an organization, it has got 3 different silos, or and now they are trying to ensure how it can be realigned so that the information can be it no longer stays silo, but the information can be shared. But and they would like to implement this as part of new ADM cycle, because it's already established, they're already having an established TOGAF 9.2 in practice. But before the start, the CIO thinks that, you know, there is a risk if we go with this approach. Okay, so the question is, you have been asked, okay, as an architect, you have been asked to recommend it, an approach to address the concern raised. The concern is that, you know, the CIO, the chairman of the board expressed that there's a risk. So how you can address that? And based on TOGAF 9.2, which of the following is the best answer? Now, you know, part 2 is an open book examination. Okay, so here I have opened the link of TOGAF document. And this, since this question falls under the category of risk management, okay, so I'm just sharing with you the TOGAF document. Okay, so if you look at here, that high level risk are considered as, you know, as or the two levels of the risk that should be considered as basically initial level and the residual level. Okay, so initial level is basically risk categorization prior to determining and implementation of mitigation actions, whereas residual level is risk categorization after the implementation of mitigation action. Okay, and the process of the risk management, as you know, you have got risk classification, identification, assessment, risk mitigation and residual risk assessment and risk monitoring. Okay, so your answer in a way should, you know, cover all these aspects of risk management. Okay, so that's kind of gives you a hint, which when we'll be looking at the option data, we'll see, you know, which of the answer basically fits up all this aspect of a risk management. Okay, so that's one of the way to, you know, identify the correct answer. Now let's look at the options. Okay, so let's look at the option. So the first option says that you recommend that a risk aversion assessment, okay, risk as aversion assessment be conducted in the implementation governance phase to determine the implementation organization's degree of risk aversion with regret to the proposed business transformation. And based on that, if the corporate board is not willing to accept the reasonable amount of risk, then you recommend they put in place a set of parallel system to mitigate the risk. Now, the issue with this answer is that, you know, in TOGAF, there's nothing called as risk aversion assessment. Okay, that's kind of completely a new term I see here. And the other thing is, if you put, things in parallel, right, that seems to be kind of excessive, okay, and it has got its own risk. Okay, but the main thing is you don't have something called as risk aversion system. So this could be, we haven't gone through all the options, but this could be the distractor, or, you know, one with the wrong option with the zero marks. Okay, so let's try to tag this as a distractor, but let's go on. Now, second option is that you recommend that techniques be used throughout the program to manage the risk, including the risk monitoring. This will enable you to identify, classify, and mitigate. Okay, very important. Identify, classify, and mitigate the risk associated with the proposed transformation, and ensure suitable business continuity plans are in place. Okay, and the implementation governance phase. Okay, you ensure a residual risk is conducted to determine the best way to manage risk that cannot be mitigated. So if you see here, this particular option, right, touches a couple of things. Okay, earlier we had seen the TOGAF document on the risk assessment. So if you look here, it talks about that, you know, you need to identify, classify, and mitigate risk. It talks about initial risk assessment. It talks about the residual initial level of risk and also the residual level of risk. Okay, so this kind of looks like a correct answer, but let's move on. Okay, so let's try to mark this as probably as a correct answer for now, but let's move on and see the option C and D. Okay, now option C is that you recommend classify the risk in terms of time, cost, and scope during the architecture vision phase. Okay, this will enable you to ensure that certain risks with certain types of impact are managed by the right individuals. You will then ensure that the architecture contract issued in the implementation governance phase address those initial risks and include adequate monitoring actions to confirm that they have been addressed. Okay, now this option does recommend, you know, conducting risk classification in phase A, okay, and the TOGAF standard does recommend that. However, the classification that being proposed here, right, it do not addresses the concern of this, you know, the whole scenario that we are trying to discuss here. And the other main thing is it does not talk or address the, you know, the risk monitoring or the management of the residual risk. Okay, so we have two kind of risk. I think we had looked at earlier in the when we were going through the TOGAF document. Initial level of risk, that's basically, you know, categorize the risk, you know, prior to determining the implementation and the mitigation action. And the second is basically the residual level of risk, which basically categorizing the risk after implementation of the mitigation action. Okay, so this particular option does not you know, address the residual part, okay, the residual risk part. So it's not as good as the option B. Okay, so this could be a second or third best answer. Okay, so we can just put here like 1-3. Okay, so either one, it can fit into either one. Okay, now let's go to the last option, option D. Now you recommend that a risk management framework is used in phase G, the implementation governance phase. This would include a risk classification scheme and completion of the worksheets for the risk assessment. This will enable you to access the risk associated with the proposed business transformation. You then ensure that the initial level of risk is well understood before issuing the architecture contract. Now, this option is less correct, okay, because it performs no risk assessment prior to the implementation governance phase. Okay, now it also does not address the risk monitoring or the management of the residual risk. Okay, similar to you know, what we have seen in option C. Okay, does not talk about the residual risk, does not talk about the monitoring, okay, which we had seen in the TOGAF document, right? It's basically risk monitoring is one of the, you know, one of the aspects of risk assessment. Okay, so option D. Now if I want to look at, you know, option C and option D, seems like it covers, it's much better than option C, but not as good as, you know, option B. So probably this will be the 3, you know, this will be the 1, and this will be 5, and this will be the 0. Okay, so the first thing, you know, in any the TOGAF part 2, you know, to tackle the TOGAF part 2 question is to, you know, basically in the scenario based question, just, you know, remove the noise. Okay, remove noise. Okay, just remove all the noise. You know, there will be a lot of noise, just remove it. Okay, there are two or three core points that you pick up from the question. Okay, look out for the distractor, because anyway the distractor is going to give you 0 mark. Okay, so look out for the distractor. Okay, stack it out. Once the distractor is gone, okay, then you have to kind of, you know, tackle between the three options. Okay, and the best way is that, you know, once we know what domain this particular question is about, like in this case it's about risk assessment, just refer to the TOGAF document. Okay, it's an open-ended part, is an open book examination. So just refer to the document, okay, and see what which answers, you know, cover most of the you know, aspects mentioned in the document. Okay, and like in this case option B is what, you know, covers most of the thing that we've seen in the TOGAF document. And then I believe once you have that, I think that's more than sufficient, right? You select option B and you'll get 5 marks. Okay, so yeah, that's about this video. Okay, just let me know in the comment section, you know, your view, or if there's any more improvement that you think I can bring out, you know, in my videos. Okay, it will be much appreciated. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe it. Okay, so stay humble. Okay, and work hard. Thank you.